Hi ho, I am Max, and because Maximum Gold Eldorado is around the corner, I decided to open some of the original Maximum Gold, being 7 packs, I think. Yeah, that should be 7. Yeah, and hope for some nice gold ultra rares and some totally awesomes or Linkaribos, because those are the best rares in this set. And yeah, maybe I'll pull some Blue Eyes, Dark Magician, Red Eyes. Something along those lines, that would be nice. Oh, Forbidden Chalice, that's an old-ish card, and Artifact Lancia, so nothing too special at the on the in the first pack. Jesus Christ. That weird Speedroid guy, Union Hangar. Lose one turn. I like this card. I'm playing this in stun-based strategies. Whoops. Barrier Statue of the Abyss. Oh, cool. Solemn Judgment. Not too valuable, but it looks nice. And Polymerization. Same thing, but yeah, I think Solemn is better money-wise and playing-wise as well. Pack number 3, and I should put the decent pulls so that we can see them. Yeehaw. Whoops. Third pack. Madolche Knights, okay. Graffa. Barrier Statue of the Torrent, Nurse Dragonmaid, meh, and Alistair, that's, I think, kind of okay-ish. I'm not too much into invoked decks, even though it's fusion-based, so that would be possible for me to play. No Synchros, no Xyz, just fusions. Another Torrent statue. The Phantom Knights of Rusty Badish, okay. And Zodiac Chaka 9. Usually Maximum Gold has some nice cards for me in store. So far in the first 4 packs that wasn't the case. Mind Control, Hatronate, Condemned Witch. Oh, okay, Ghost Ogre is not too bad, and Ash Blossom is very good. So, Hand Traps pack. Whoops. I should probably hold the sleeves in the right direction. Two packs left. Tricks Ionara or what? Ionaya. Oh cool, Linkaribo. Good rare. Dark Lord Contact, Marshall Metal Marcher, and another Jackanine. And the last pack. That's more of a quick video, but why not? Buster Blade, the Destruction Swordsman. Man, these cards are hard to read. Mistaken Arrest. Number 39, Utopia Beyond. The Whitestone of Ancients. Lost World. Oh, okay. Eldritch. I think he has got another reprint in Eldorado with an alternate art. So he shouldn't be too valuable anymore. But Nitz is nice. Because why not? I think when the set came out it wasn't too crazy in value, but now it's like 8 to 9 euro, I think. So towards the end there were some nice pulls in here. Mainly the Ash and Hints, but also one of the two good rares with Linkaribo. So I have had crazier openings of Mago, but yeah, this one is about what you can expect, I think. Some good stuff and yeah, some cards that look nice but aren't too crazy in my opinion. So yeah, see you next time for the Maximum Gold Eldorado opening, as soon as I can get my boxes that I ordered. So yeah, until then, see you next time on Random Old School Yu-Gi-Oh! Goodbye and stay safe!